We're live.
On it.
We're live. The cameras are on now. Welcome to Facebook. Welcome to Film Companion at Facebook. It's a show that I host out of Bandstand at the Facebook office. So I'm glad that you have chosen this platform to make your first social media appearance.
Thank you for having me.
I should just let you know that we're going to have people tuning in, all set to ask you questions. They probably waited a long time because you haven't been on social media at all.
Yeah.
So we'll wait a couple of minutes just to have people tune in. It's a good time for me to welcome you guys and tell you that this is your chance to send in your questions directly to KK Menon. I promise to take screen as many questions as possible. I have a screen in front of me, so I'm going to be watching and I will try and take as many questions as possible. But first things first, like I said, this is social media debut for you. What made you finally bite the bug?
Though very late in life, I realized that people, initially I used to always have this constant answer that I keep the face and the book separate. I deal with people face to face and I read my books, things like that. But today I realize that nobody looks at your face. Everybody's into some device and I didn't want to be left out. So I thought I'll just join the whole stream and see where it goes. It's a very responsible medium. I mean, I think it's one of those double-edged swords.
It's how you use
yeah,
it also.
It's a double-edged sword, so if you want to use it well, it'll do you good. Yeah. So
yeah.
And I hope I shall be responsible enough to do it.
But what has been the biggest deterrent for you all these years in very consciously staying away from it?
Actually, it was not, I don't know if it's conscious or not, because that would sound very uppity.
Planned
yeah.
and
that's not
strategized.
Right. Nothing like that. I just felt that I didn't need to use it. But then now I realize that everybody is on it. And if you have to talk about your films, I don't really talk about myself. I'm not a narcissist, so I really don't like doing that about myself. But your work, etc., etc., it becomes a very important platform, social media, is what I've guessed. So I said, let's try this once and see how it goes.
Okay. So it's up to you guys to basically show him a whole lot of love just to ensure that he doesn't change his mind soon enough. Because right before this chat, you were telling me that you get bored very easily.
Yes, I do. Yeah, that's one thing, yeah. I don't get bored of tennis. I mean, my sports and acting and cinema. The other thing is just constant in my life. So I don't get bored of that. Rest, I'm not very sure.
You know, I was doing a chat with Rajkumar Rao recently, the actor, and I had asked him about if he could go back to himself making his debut and what is that one piece of advice he would give to young actors. And he had said to me then that he wished he knew the importance of having a PR team and just some missionary that would help you get the word out. How do you stand and what do you feel about the importance of PR or just putting yourself out there as an actor today?
See, I always make a distinction between voice and noise. Okay?
Okay.
So for me, voice is very important. So if you are able to provide that, then I'm on for it. But if it's just noise, then it's cacophony. And normally, I'm not that kind of person who would indulge in cacophony. So I as a person, so I think voice is very important. If you can make your voice heard in the right platform, the right way. Like I said, it's a double-edged sword. So I can keep on shouting or I can just have once in a while a voice coming in of certain opinions, certain things.
You know, for someone who's doing your first Facebook Live, I feel like it's my moral duty to tell you that there is a lot of noise on social media.
That's one thing which I know already.
How are you planning to maybe filter the noise? And
you know what happens once in a while when you speak, people listen to you. But if you speak all the time, people don't listen to you.
Very valuable words of wisdom coming in there. You know, for those of you guys tuning in just a little bit late to the chat, welcome to Film Companion at Facebook. On the show today with me, a newbie, a social media newbie, KK Menon has stopped by Bandstand at the Facebook office. And it's great to have you here. Like I was telling you guys, it's a good chance for you to send in your questions as well. Stuff that you've been wanting to ask him. What is your social media handle? Have you familiarized yourself with these terms?
I normally do get a handle of things. And I'm very easy with that. So I've made sure that I know at least that KKMNN02 is what the handle is. And it's a pretty...
Is it because decent. You didn't get KKMNN as is or why the handle?
No, I prefer the 02 kind of. I prefer to be second. So this something to
out
look
of
forward.
Choice.
Yeah, something to look forward to. If you're number one, there's nothing more left in life, you see. So when you're number two, you know that there's some one more ladder to climb. So I was always like, and secondly, it also seems very modest. So it's very nice. It's a kind of a humble thing to do, you know. So yeah, that's the reason.
So KK Menon 02 is the handle that you guys should be looking out for on Facebook, on Instagram.
Yes.
You're going all out.
All out, Twitter, everything.
Do it, then do it all out.
All out, yeah, absolutely.
How many hours of your day have you promised to? Okay, so you must have PR managers who are obviously advising you on how
yes.
this is important.
Yes,
so what
yes.
are the do's and the don'ts that have already been filled into your head?
I have been asking a lot of pertinent questions.
Being
that I get, the moment this thing was put there were too many friend requests coming from unknown parties. So I asked Priyanka, who's handling it, do I accept them? I don't mind accepting friends in real life, but this is a different media, you see, where imposters also are genuine, so I don't know. So she said, no, hold on, there will be a fan page which everybody can have access to. That's a better deal, otherwise I'll keep only answering. And I believe that if they are my friends, they can pick up a phone and call me and chat with me.
Mm-hmm.
This is for a different purpose altogether. This
yeah.
is more work oriented.
So what people can expect from your social media page would be updates about
yes.
work?
Yes.
Continuous updates?
Updates about work, some random unsolicited thoughts perhaps, I don't know. Irrelevant sometimes relevant. But mostly relevant, yeah.
Yeah? Okay. So I should tell you that we have a whole bunch of comments and questions and all kinds of things flowing in. So I will try and screen a bunch and take as many as I can. Lots of love and best wishes also coming in for you. When is your next? That is going to be a repeated question. Abhishek Joshi is talking to you. So
yes,
that.
Abhishek. When is my next?
When is your next film?
Oh, yeah. The next film that would release would be, I think, Vodka Diaries. It's an interesting psychological thriller which we shot in Manali. It has myself, Mandira and Raima. Nicely done. So that's my next one. Yeah.
Kashish wants to know from you, Kashish Tandon, do you think you are an underrated actor?
Rating is something that I don't know of. I don't have any expertise in that department. So rating is something that you should ask the raters. So for me, I'm an actor. And I think all that should be left to the pundits and questions to the pundits as to where they rate me and things like that. So as long as I feel that I'm not undercut in any way, I'm fine.
Guys, thank you so much for sending in your questions. I'm going to try and screen as many as possible. There's one from Arash Agarwal who wants to know, who's your personal favorite from the current lot? Are you very up to date in terms of films today?
Arush, aisa hai na ki if I make a list of favorites, then there are number of people who will be unhappy with me. Okay, so I don't want to do that. So I would rather keep those favorites to myself. But I believe that the new crop know what they're doing. I think they have a better, as you said, handle on things, and they know their craft very well. So which I'm very happy about.
Yeah, but do you think at some point, just to get your view on this, that the noise, like you were talking about, takes away from the core of acting? Because now you see behind the scenes, you see actors posting gym photos. I mean, abs don't make you a better actor, do they?
Mm-hmm.
So do you, at any point, does that maybe deter you that it could, the noise around it is so much more than the voice?
I think, the difference being that if you are aware of the fact that you are being, you have to be acting all the time, in front of the camera, behind the camera, etc., etc., then there's a problem and you better not do it, because then you'll be doomed. The idea is that if your expertise lies in a particular profession, stick to it. The rest will follow. So for me, it's not necessary that I should be acting out behind the camera, even if I'm on camera at that point in time, since that's not my profession. My profession is to actually act in front of the camera for a particular screenplay. So that's it. The moment I'm out of it, I don't care what I'm wearing. I don't care about anything else. So it's very specific in my case. So my sincere advice is, chhod do yaar, kuch nahi hota hai. You just be normal in real life. If people want to capture you like that, it's fine. If you have a little bad hair, it's fine. Not a big deal. what is most important is how do you look on screen, how, what do you do on screen when you're working. And body achieve aate, it's very good. I mean, you can have a nice physique, but that should not be the yardstick for acting. That's the only thing. So concentrate more on the body of work than the physical body.
Mm-hmm. I was chatting with Adil Hussain this one time, who had very openly admitted that he does some work for the dil and some for the bill. Is that a predicament you often face as an actor as well?
I would rather that my work subsidizes my life. I do all work for dil and bill. So for me, I don't think I would just do it for the bill. If I'm doing for the bill, I'll put my dil into it. And if I'm doing for the dil, then the bill has to be paid, boss. I'm sorry.
But that must be hard, right? How do you know when a film is being pitched to you, right at the pitching stage itself, that this is not going to go anywhere? Does that happen to you, that you just get pitched very random scripts as well?
I have made mistakes. I mean, definitely everybody. I'm a human being after all. I can give you free advice, but that doesn't mean that I
take it
haven't,
yourself.
Haven't made mistakes. But all the more reason that, yes, I have made a lot of mistakes. But I don't know the reason really. I think it was more to do with that moment. I've just felt this should be done. And it happened. And nothing came of it. So fine, you just move ahead and just do the next thing that's best for you.
Mm-hmm. Moving ahead is fine, but that's, you're moving ahead to the next film. But what happens if you fall out of love with a script while you're working in it? Does that happen at all to actors, that you do fall out of a story at a given time?
I think that's why this word commitment has been engineered, right, in life.
So, stay committed.
Yeah. So if you have already fallen in love, you might as well complete that love and stay committed to it, even though you're not in love.
All right. So, okay, again, everyone seems to want to know your favorite actor in Bollywood, but since you don't want to upset the others, we'll keep that out of it. Is there a Hollywood character that you want to play? Harshit wants to know.
Nay, this is again one of those dream role questions, right? I think
it is,
yes.
It is.
Which I
There's
often
no
get.
There's no such yeah. thing as a...
So I dream separately at night and then I do my role separately. Mm-hmm. So I don't have a dream role.
Harshit again wants to know how you prepare for a role. That's interesting actually. I do want to understand from you. How do you really get into the headspace of a character? Is there anything specific you do? I've heard of actors who listen to specific music, or some Vidya Balan had once talked to us about how she used a particular perfume and that helped her go back to the character. And she, even when she promoted the film, she would just spray that perfume to go back to that space. Do you have anything at all like that that you resort to?
My nasal instincts are not so good, but all I can say is that my process is quite boring, in the sense that I'm at it all the time. I sort of read the text a number of times, and that gives me something, which I often use this as an example to people who ask me this, that Aladdin ka chirag hota na, so you keep rubbing it, and somebody from outside will feel, what the hell is he doing here, it's such a boring job. Suddenly when Aladdin, some form will come out from that. That's the process for me. Just keep rubbing that script, and in a sense, just keep reading it, and suddenly you'll find a form which you think, ah, this is it, and then that's when the Eureka moment happens. So for me, that is how I work, and I normally, as I said earlier also in many interviews, that I don't do roles. I play people. Roles are very finite in nature. You might be a role of a teacher, a cop, or whatever. 25,000 roles must be existing in this world. They're very finite. People are infinite. Like Sneha, and suppose there's one more girl called Rita, who are both interviewing me. Both are interviewing me. The job is as an interviewer. But they are different people.
Sure.
So I play people. So if I am playing Mahesh the cop or Suresh the cop, I play Mahesh and Suresh, not the cop. The moment you start playing the cop, then you become very limited, because then wahi hota hai ki right hand mein danda hota hai aur left hand mein maarte rehte ho. That's how you normally play a role. So I tend to play people. So I people are infinite in nature.
Yeah.
So that's my take on how I prepare myself.
That's excellent acting advice as well, because a lot of people who consume Film Companion are aspiring actors. So many of y'all have questions for him and have been sending it in as well. So make sure you keep sending them in. But if I were to ask you, what is the best practical piece of acting advice that you have received from somebody, something that that's almost held you in good stead as a tool that you use? Has there been anything like that?
Learn your lines and don't bump into the furniture.
Is that Nasiruddin Shah?
that's Nasir, which obviously he says. I found very simplistic and very relevant, because the more you start hyping the idea of acting, the more you're going to fall into a trap. Keep it as simple as possible. Do what suits you the best, what gets. Like, for example, like you said, Vidya found that the smell. You might find something like that. I think each one to his own. The best part about Stanislavski is that he didn't say it's the method of acting. He said it's method acting. So it can be anything. It can be your method, anybody's method.
Mm-hmm.
So for me, and try not to read too many books on acting. It will just bias you unnecessarily. Try and read biographies if possible. Try and read stuff, because then you can identify when the person says the smell of the studio, you can identify with it because you've been to a studio. So it's always better to learn through experiences of other people than actually reading techniques of acting, which is never the same. Acting is too intangible to, as it's famously said, that you can't teach acting, but you can learn acting.
Mm-hmm. You brought up method acting, and that's really something that has intrigued me for a long time. I often wonder, I mean, the extent to which an actor pushes himself just in the quest of a character. You guys do some pretty incredible things to your mind and your body. What has been some of the most punishing things? Is that something that you'd want to throw light on, method acting?
No, method acting is the most often misused word. It's overused and hardly understood by people.
For example, do you allow yourself in your real life to feel an emotion, or are you constantly thinking about when you could perhaps utilize this emotion that you're feeling on camera?
No. I don't live my life as a spectator of myself. No, I don't do that at all. I live my life the way it is, and acting is a part of my life. The point still remains that you'll have to, there are a few things which you have to do like in every other profession. One is you have to practice.
Sure.
You have to hone your skills, you hone your tools, like whatever you have, to keep it ready for an occasion that comes to you. Number two is that method acting bhool jao, because that's something after 20, 30 years of experience in actual acting, then perhaps you might understand what he's trying to say. So it's I think personally it's not very fruitful to go straight bang on there, because you'll start studying it like a student, and that's not what is required in that book by Stanislavski. Anyway, and each to his own, as I said, the method is each to his own. For example, some people might like to sing before reading a script or while reading a script. I don't know. Each can find his own grain and go ahead with that and see how it goes. There's no one
do
particular
you, push? I mean, do you push yourself a lot more? I mean, is it punishing in any sense?
No. It's involving yourself, nothing else. I don't think by punishing you achieve anything.
I mean, you read reports of, say, a Rajkumar Rao who survived on what, one carrot and two coffees throughout the shooting of Trapped, and you just wonder, wow, that it's not a glamorous world out there. There's a lot that goes into becoming.
Yeah, it's not a, I mean, glamour.
It's not just glamour.
Yeah, it's not just glamour. A lot of hard work in terms of like anything else. I mean, when you see a rocket flying, it's glamorous, yeah. But, you know, when you see it on TV, just the way it
taking
shoots
off,
up, you just feel it's glamorous, but it's not. You have a lot of work behind it. Similarly, in any other profession, I'm sure in your profession, I mean, everybody has a lot of hard work behind something that is finally put in front of you. So I think the same goes with acting. So it's nothing to be glorified about. Mm-hmm. I think it's the same.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Let's take a couple of questions that you guys have been sending in live. Iresh Gupta wants to know, of all your roles that you have done, do you have a personal favorite?
I'm lucky.
Saw this coming.
Yeah, these are multiple choice questions, I call them. I think about 13, 14 of my entire repertoire of work, 13, 14 films in which I've played some decent stuff, I've done some decent stuff, is what I can say. And which is a good ratio, because mm-hmm. I think it's about 1/10 of my work, which is not bad. I think De Niro also doesn't have that kind of.
Do you have a personal favorite there?
No, there are 14
of them. You're not going to name any.
I shall throw it out to you and you can choose.
Maybe you guys should send us in what you think were his.
See, Shakespeare once upon a time in his plays had said once that the eye knows not itself but by reflection.
So you are that reflection.
So you are the person who left.
Jimmy Gill wants to know, will you direct ever?
I would like to ask Jimmy, are you bored of my acting? at the moment, no. Direction requires a lot of patience, a lot of different skill set. At the moment, I'm pretty okay as an actor and I'm enjoying the process. So mm-hmm. The day I get bored of that, I shall shift to something else.
Chinmoy, that should answer your question as well. So clearly a lot of people looking towards you to direct a film. That is interesting. Do you ever plan to be in a reality show or on a small screen project? Kuntal.
The screen size doesn't define my my interest. The content does. So if it's small screen, tiny screen, mega screen, doesn't matter to me. As long as the content is there, I'm fine with it.
Mm-hmm. There's another question that says that most of your movies have been in the space of drama, thriller, documentary. Would you ever opt for a typical commercial script? Is that even a way that you...
Are you trying to say that my films don't make money? Because commercial is to do with commerce. I think that's the whole definition. Some of them did make money, I must say, because in that sense, I've already done commercial films.
Mm-hmm. But I think what he was going for is the hardcore masala script. Is that something that a sensibility that you relate to at all?
The thing about masala is that it can cause you indigestion, it can cause you acidity, it can cause you a lot of problems, you know, in terms of your health. So for me, I will take that much masala which is okay with my health.
So running around trees is not something that...
Well, I can run very fast. I mean, I used to be a sprinter once upon a time. I run very well as well, gracefully. But if it's for a purpose, it's better.
That should answer your question. You know, since this... Okay, for those of you guys actually tuning in just a little bit late, I should tell you guys that KK Menon has finally decided to take the plunge and get onto social media. His handle is KKMenon02. And if you guys want to know the interesting story behind that, maybe you want to go follow him on Twitter, Instagram, Facebook.
Yeah.
Have you got on Snapchat as well, or we'll save
that's
for
later?
Save that for later in the day. So I'm actually going to quiz you a little bit on how well you know social media since you've decided to take the plunge. What's the first app you check when you wake up in the morning?
First app I check. Actually, I don't check my phone in the morning. I try to get my thoughts aligned and then I shall check my the app. I think normally messaging happens on WhatsApp. So yeah, so WhatsApp is something that would. But first thing in the morning is a very wrong question for me. It doesn't happen.
Kids learn, listen, make notes.
I definitely check it. Yeah, I shall.
How many selfies do you take in a day?
Selfies? No, I have none. I don't have the habit of taking selfies at all. None.
You're going to have to do this if you...
Yeah, I'll ask somebody to take a snap because I don't...
That's not a selfie.
Yeah, true. Although I have very long. Kanun ke haath hai, lambe hai. But often when fans come, I take their phone, say, okay, fine, here it is. Okay, happy.
That's done. What's the last thing you Googled?
Last thing I Googled... what did I Google last? I Googled someone to repair my electronic thing in the house. Yeah, there's some
real
problem with my projector. Yeah. So I wanted to find out who can do that best. Yeah, I did that. Yeah.
How often do you Google yourself? Do you have a Google alert set for your name?
No, nothing. I'm really one of those very non-narcissistic guys coming onto the social media. So please forgive me if I'm saying something wrong.
It's going to be fun to watch what you're going to be up to on social media.
Yeah.
Considering you don't even post selfies because you'd assume that's what it's about.
Yeah. I've told Priyanka that please do the needful these things because I have no idea.
All the best to Priyanka. Yeah. She's going to need it.
Yeah.
But yeah, like I said, he's taken the plunge and gotten on social media. KK Menon is 02 is his handle on Facebook. So I think we're basically opening our account with this Facebook live chat. So maybe you want to just tell everyone who's tuning in, who's watching you right now, why they should follow you, because that's the term, by the way, they follow you on Facebook.
I don't know.
You
really
can't do this.
Yeah, I can't. I can't really ask people to follow me, because I would rather that when I look back, if I find a few of you behind me who are following me, it'll be great. But no stress, huh? Just relax. If you don't feel like following, don't follow. But if you feel like following, just throw in a little, you know, whatever you call it.
Hit the like button.
Yeah, yeah.
And you can follow KK Menon on Facebook, on Instagram.
Koi stress nahi bhaiya. Pehle keh raha hu.
Thank you so much for coming by the Facebook office and joining us on Film Companion at Facebook. Thank you guys so much for tuning into this live chat. It's been great fun. Thank you so much for all your questions. I tried to take as many as I could. Just in case you missed the first part of this chat, you can catch it on the Film Companion page. So make sure you check it out. You should, for starters, share this chat on your page. I hope I've familiarized you with some terms.
Handle, share, follow.
You can do it. You're set for the social media world.
Yeah,
thank you so much, guys. See you soon.